Hello guys, welcome to GMAT Point. In this video, we'll be discussing about how to prepare for GMAT and CAT simultaneously and the advantages of preparing for both these exams together and also the detailed preparation strategy to prepare for both the exams together. The GMAT and the CAT are very popular MBA entrance exams taken by the aspirants who wish to pursue MBA from their dream B-school, and these exams are among some of the toughest entrance exams to crack. CAT is an entrance exam that is important for getting admissions into the premier B schools to pursue an MBA in India, and on the other hand, the GMAT is an entrance exam that is essential to pursue MBA in premier institutes in India or abroad. Once you decided to pursue MBA, the first question is which entrance exam to give. And if you've decided to prepare for both the exams, the next question would be how to strategically prepare for GMAT and CAT together. Will CAT preparation be helpful in GMAT preparation, or will GMAT preparation be helpful in CAT preparation? Or is GMAT enough for the CAT preparation, etc., etc. So these are some of the frequently asked questions by a lot of MBA aspirants. One can prepare for both these exams simultaneously, and as mentioned, there are some advantages of preparing together. That is because the preparation of one exam helps the other exam. So we'll be discussing all those advantages, and we'll also see how to use the CAT preparation to crack the GMAT. The key differences between CAT and GMAT in terms of syllabus, the concepts tested, and also we'll see which exam is easier or tougher. So we'll look at the toughness of the exams and all the other key things that will help you strategically plan your preparation for both these exams. So let's get started. So if you're someone who's planning to take the GMAT examination along with the CAT, you can kickstart your GMAT preparation with GMAT Point. So we are offering a lot of free resources at GMAT Point, which you can utilize during your GMAT preparation. So firstly, you can take these 5 free topic tests, each on the verbal and the quant section. Additionally, we are offering free GMAT daily tests. So we will be providing some free tests every day, and these tests are extremely beneficial during your GMAT preparation. You can take these on our website gmatpoint.com. And these free GMAT daily tests are starting from October 1st. So you can take this test starting from October 1st, and additionally, we will also be providing video solutions for each of these tests. So you can go to our website, take these tests and make the most out of them. We also have a Telegram group for GMAT aspirants, wherein you can post and discuss your queries. It is very essential to have a good peer group during your GMAT preparation. This keeps you motivated and will also help you discuss various concepts, test taking strategies, mistakes and so on with your peers and also exam experts. If you have any queries regarding the GMAT preparation or regarding the free tests, you can reach out to us at support@gmatpoint.com. You can also WhatsApp us or call us on this number 630-323-9042. Okay, so let's look at the preparation strategy for both CAT and GMAT. Firstly, let's quickly take a look at the exam patterns for both these exams. So we know that the GMAT or Graduate Management Admission Test is one of the widely taken MBA entrance exams globally, and it's organized by the GMAC. It tests the analytical and critical thinking abilities of the candidate, and GMAT is a computer adaptive test, and this is the exam pattern of the GMAT. So we have these four sections: quantitative reasoning, 31 questions, 62 minutes, verbal reasoning, 36 questions, 65 minutes. Then we have the integrated reasoning and analytical writing assessment section. Here we have 12 questions, here we have one topic, basically you have to write an essay here, and the time limit is 30 minutes each. The total GMAT score is out of 800, and these two sections are the sections that are included in your total score. And as mentioned, since GMAT is one of the most widely taken MBA entrance exams globally, one usually needs a GMAT score of 650 plus or 700 plus to apply to the top B schools around the world. And coming to the CAT, the Common Admission Test is an MBA entrance exam that is conducted by the IIMs, and it's the biggest national level MBA entrance exam in India. Every year, more than 2 lakh candidates appear for the CAT, and this is the exam pattern of the CAT based on the CAT 2020. So these are the three sections that are tested in the CAT: verbal ability, reading comprehension, then logical reasoning and data interpretation, and quantitative ability. The time limit for each section is 40 minutes. So as we can see, there's no huge difference in terms of syllabus for both these exams. CAT syllabus is based on topics such as English, quant and logical reasoning, whereas GMAT is majorly based on quantitative reasoning and verbal reasoning. But of course, the exam pattern for both these exams is different. So both these exams are very important exams for graduate students who are planning to pursue MBA. And if you're trying to choose one exam, and if you're someone trying to see which exam is easier, first, we must understand that it's not wise to choose an entrance exam depending on how easy or tough the exam is, because the exams are neither too easy nor too tough, and one needs to work equally hard for them. The difficulty level for each exam differs for each exam and also from candidate to candidate. You can also prepare for both these exams and also give both the exams. And one important question asked by a lot of aspirants is, does my CAT preparation help in the GMAT? So if you have already prepared for CAT or preparing for CAT, and if you are thinking if the CAT preparation would be helpful in the GMAT preparation, the answer is yes, it would be helpful. Although the syllabus for both these exams is slightly different, you can definitely use the skills learned while preparing for CAT to prepare for the GMAT. So if you're already well versed with the topics that appear in the CAT exam, you need to additionally prepare for the critical reasoning and the sentence correction topics in the GMAT verbal section and the data sufficiency section in the GMAT quant section. Also, if you have decided to give both these exams, it is usually recommended to start with CAT preparation first rather than the other way around. The reason is simple, because if you start with GMAT preparation first and then later proceed to CAT, you need to prepare more for the quant section of the CAT, because the GMAT quant section is kind of a subset to the CAT quant section. So if you start with GMAT first and then proceed to CAT, you need to prepare more for the quant section, and also you need to prepare for a whole new section in the CAT called the LRDI section. And hence it's advisable to start with CAT preparation first, and if you've covered all the concepts in CAT thoroughly, by the time you proceed to GMAT, you would have covered almost 60 to 70% of the GMAT syllabus. Okay, now why should you prepare for GMAT along with the CAT? So there are some advantages of preparing for GMAT along with CAT. That is because the GMAT gives the candidate the flexibility to take the exam anytime during the year, and one can also take the GMAT exam up to 5 times in a year. Also, the GMAT score is valid for 5 years, and the GMAT scores are accepted in many B schools across the world. Additionally, GMAT also allows you the flexibility of building your profile before you start your MBA. This is because you need to get some work experience before you start your MBA. So you can build your profile during that time, and that will be very helpful before you start your MBA program. And it also does not take too many months to prepare for the GMAT exam if one prepares with proper planning and seriousness. And also, as mentioned, if you are well versed with the CAT syllabus, you would additionally need 2 to 3 months of preparation to crack the GMAT. So these are the major advantages of preparing for GMAT along with the CAT and taking GMAT along with the CAT exam. Okay, so now let's delve deeper into how to prepare for GMAT and CAT together. So if you have already prepared for the CAT, or if you are preparing for the CAT, we will see how to utilize that to prepare for the GMAT in a strategic manner. So firstly, you must start your GMAT preparation by taking a mock test. As mentioned earlier, we are providing a lot of free topic tests. You can take this on our website and you can assess your strengths and weaknesses in each of the quant and the verbal section. And depending on your weak and strong areas, you need to devise a study plan, especially addressing the weak areas. Now let us see how to prepare for each section of the GMAT individually. Let's start with the GMAT verbal section. As we all know, the verbal section of the GMAT is more challenging than that of the CAT, because here more concepts are tested. The GMAT verbal section tests more of your critical reasoning skills, grammar, and the three subtopics that are tested in the GMAT verbal section are reading comprehension, critical reasoning, and sentence correction. The reading comprehension section in the CAT and GMAT are very close. And if you're someone who already scored a 95+ percentile in the CAT VARC, then that means that you have a good grasp of the VARC concepts and you don't have to prepare much for the reading comprehension part of the GMAT. You need to focus more on the critical reasoning and the sentence correction. And the major focus has to be on the sentence correction part. As mentioned, the level of RCs in CAT and GMAT are almost similar. And to improve your reading comprehension skills, develop a habit of reading every day and also read various articles from international newspapers and magazines. This will help you improve your reading comprehension abilities. And in the CR section, the critical reasoning section, this is a separate section in the GMAT. So it basically evaluates the candidate's ability to construct and analyze arguments and formulate and evaluate a plan of action. In CAT also we have critical reasoning questions, but the critical reasoning questions are a part of RCs in the CAT. But in GMAT, they constitute a separate section, and these are relatively tougher than the CAT CR questions. But if you've already prepared for the CAT and if you scored a good percentile, this will not be a very tough section to crack in the GMAT. And the major focus in GMAT has to be on the sentence correction, because this is completely new and this is not tested in CAT. So this is one of the very important sections in GMAT verbal that candidates must focus on. So in this section, basically the candidates have to select those expressions which are grammatically and structurally sound basically the sentence correction tests your grammar skills here. And then next, if we look at the GMAT quant section, so here the quantitative section, the quantitative reasoning section of the GMAT is not as tough as compared to that of the CAT exam. The CAT quant syllabus is quite substantial and requires more time to prepare. So the CAT quant is relatively tougher and tests more concepts. And on the other hand, GMAT quant does not require much time to prepare. And if you have already prepared for CAT, the time required to prepare for GMAT quant is much lesser. Also, the GMAT quant syllabus is a subset of the CAT quant syllabus. But in GMAT quant, two additional topics such as the number properties. So the number properties topic needs more effort. So this topic under the GMAT tests your basics more. So you need to put in some additional effort to prepare for this topic, and also the statistics topic. This is also tested in the GMAT, but you need to be aware of the basics of this concept. Again, this is not a very tough topic in the GMAT, just that you need to cover all the basics related to the statistics and practice a few sums, then you will get comfortable with both these topics. And the GMAT quant section has two parts. One is the problem solving and the other one is data sufficiency. And this part is not very tough if you've already prepared well for the CAT quants. And this is an important section in the GMAT quants, and this requires some additional practice. So this data sufficiency questions evaluate your ability to analyze a quantitative issue, determine whether the data given is relevant, and assess if enough information is available to solve a problem. So while preparing for GMAT, this has to be the major area of focus, because the data sufficiency questions are not very easy and they require additional practice. And with practice, of course, this is also not a tough section to crack. And one should also spend some time practicing some mental calculations every day to improve the calculation speed. Because remember that a calculator will not be available for the GMAT quant section, so your speed is also important. And try to spend around 10 to 15 minutes every day to practice some simple speed math calculations. And finally, these are the two additional sections in the GMAT. This is one section that is not present in the CAT and is unique to the GMAT exam. So in the analytical writing assessment section, you will be presented with an argument and you're expected to write an essay about it. Although this section is not counted towards your final score, you need to prepare well for this section, and it's not a very difficult section to prepare for. The purpose is to evaluate the candidate's ability to think critically and convey his or her thoughts in writing. And then the integrated reasoning section of the GMAT is a recent addition to the exam syllabus. And this section evaluates your ability to analyze and evaluate data in various formats. So it tests your ability to evaluate data provided in the form of graph or a table. And this integrated reasoning section in the GMAT is not computer adaptive. So only the quant and the verbal sections are computer adaptive. And also this section of the GMAT is not exactly like the LRDI section of the CAT. And it is definitely not as tough as the LRDI section of the CAT. And your score in this section of GMAT is not counted towards your final score. Okay, so finally, how much time is required to prepare for both the exams? That is the CAT and the GMAT. So firstly, the time required to prepare for the exam depends on the candidate's ability to grasp the concepts. And for students who are starting from scratch, usually take 6 to 8 months to prepare for the CAT. And on the other hand, students starting from the scratch take around 5 to 6 months to prepare for the GMAT. And if you're already well versed with the concepts tested in the CAT, then you would only need 2 to 3 months additionally to prepare for the GMAT. And also, usually the time required to prepare for GMAT is less than the time required to prepare for CAT. And if you have scored 95 plus percentile in the CAT in both the verbal and the quant section, so if you score 95 percentile each in both the sections, an additional preparation of 2 months would suffice for the GMAT preparation. And if you are someone who scored around 90 percentile in the CAT in both the sections, then you would require at least 3 months to prepare for and crack the GMAT. And if you scored less than 90 percentile in CAT in both the sections, then you would have to work much harder for the GMAT. You would need more time, especially on the data sufficiency questions of the GMAT quant and also the critical reasoning and sentence correction of the verbal section of the GMAT. Also, an overall score of 700 in the GMAT would be roughly around 88 percentile. So achieving a score of 88 to 90 percentile in the GMAT for someone who already scored a 95 plus percentile in both these sections of CAT, that is VRC and the quantitative section, achieving this score in the GMAT is not a very tough job. So all it takes is an organized preparation plan and a few weeks of hard work. So while preparing for GMAT, try to spend at least 2 hours every day over the weekdays and more time on the weekends. So overall, roughly try to spend 18 to 20 hours per week on your GMAT preparation. And if you already prepared well for the CAT, you need to put in only some additional efforts for the GMAT. This is because the CAT is not a computer adaptive test, and whereas the GMAT is a computer adaptive test. So one must get used to this format of test taking. Also, unlike in CAT, you cannot skip any questions in the GMAT, quant and the verbal section. Also, you cannot go back to the previous questions in the GMAT. Hence, the candidates must get used to this format of test taking. So taking the free topic tests that I mentioned at the start, so taking these tests regularly will be extremely beneficial to the candidates in building these test taking abilities. And these topic tests and the free daily tests that we are providing on our website, these tests are curated to match the difficulty level and the test taking format of the GMAT, and hence these are highly recommended. And finally, is coaching needed to prepare for both these exams? And the answer is yes. One would definitely need coaching or external mentorship to prepare together for both the GMAT and the CAT. You can check out the details of the free topic test and the GMAT daily test under the description box below. And if you have any other doubts regarding the GMAT exam or these tests or preparation related queries, please post them in the comment section below. We'll try to address your queries immediately. Also, do join the Telegram group. That will be extremely beneficial during your preparation. Thank you for watching.